Hi, how are you?
Hi, Deb.
Hi. First of all, I just want to say thank you for all that you do and all that you are. And I've already felt like I've had a reading already this evening from your previous caller with Jennifer. Bunch of Me Too moments
Great.
during that call.
I love the lingo. You know the lingo, me too. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you so much for saying that. You know, if you're familiar with my work, then you know that my whole goal is to raise awareness and to teach. That's my goal. I love to share this subject matter in a very, very real way. Are you developing? Are you working on your development? Is that what your course of kind of action is, or is it just something that you're interested in?
Just something that I'm interested in, albeit I've had people tell me that it's something that I should pursue, but I really don't know in what respect. And so, again, the information that you gave to Jennifer earlier about just letting, something, just letting it, yourself, be pulled to something and, looking at it in that regard.
Well, one of the things that the last book, Infinite Quest, was I dedicated the book to Sandy Anastasi, and she's the only person who can actually claim to be my teacher in my development process. And I am so excited that we actually have her doing her psychic development classes here on the site. So I know that that's on there. You might want to check that out. What questions do you have for me? What can I help you with tonight?
I really don't have any questions. I'm just excited to, for the opportunity,
Well, very
and
cool.
I'm happy to talk to anybody who wants to come through.
Very cool. Well, the first thing I'm going to tell you is that I'm seeing the month of February. So I don't know if there was anything that transitioned in February for you.
Yes.
If somebody, took ill or if they passed in February. Does that make sense?
It a recent February transition was a job that I just got on the West Coast and made a move from the East Coast.
How different is that?
It's very different.
It must,
I've only been.
yeah. It's gotta feel like. I know the first time I went from New York to LA, and I wasn't even working. I just remember feeling off, like energetically. I was like, "Oh, this is very, very weird." Are you still there?
Yeah, that's exactly right. That's exactly how I feel.
I don't know what's going on with where you're living, or if you're gonna be shifting where you're living again. Like in other words, like you landed where you are, and that this is gonna be temporary, and then you're gonna move again. But I'm getting the feeling of like. Shift again, and
Okay.
like another shift kind of energy that comes up. I have to say that I think that there's going to be an issue about pets or something about a pet. So I don't know if you're having a thing about wanting to get one and you're going to be in a place where you can't, or if there's going to be an. Do you have pets now?
I do, and there was an issue actually about getting finding a residence here in California that accepted animals that dogs that were over 25 pounds.
Okay, so this is what you're dealing with. Do you know if there's a brother figure who's passed or somebody that would see as being a contemporary, somebody to your side?
A contemporary, yes.
Male.
Yes.
Okay, I have a male contemporary that's showing up and making me feel like he's like the husband brother energy, and he's making me feel like I'm watching what you're doing. I'm acknowledging like the shifts. He's acknowledging the issue with the pet, and to show you that you're not alone. Sometimes you kind of go to a place of feeling like you're isolated. Well, you'll sometimes put yourself in a place of being isolated and emotionally will feel alone sometimes, but it's like of your own doing, and you kind of do that to kind of keep the world at abeyance so you don't lose your balance. And I totally understand that. Some people listening to that might not be like, I don't get that, but you know what I mean when I say that?
Exactly.
Okay, you do this on purpose to kind of achieve like we keep the you shut the doors to keep the noise out, and he's
Exactly.
making me like be careful about doing it to a point of being not antisocial, but. Creating a place for you where you're feeling more isolated and feeling more alone. Now, has your biological father passed?
Yes.
Okay, your dad is definitely here, but whenever I use the word biological, it always lets me know there's another one because now I can differentiate the two. So your biological father's passed. Would there be a stepfather or a father-in-law who's passed as well? Or an ex-father-in-law?
Well, there could, I mean, there's an ex-father-in-law that I didn't know.
Who's passed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And there's somebody who either was paralyzed on one side or somebody who had a problem with one side of their body, where there's like one side seems to be not functioning. So whether it be they couldn't move their arm, they couldn't move their leg, I'm not really sure, but I know it's on one side of their body that I see a paralysis. And they're telling me to talk about the E name. So I don't know if there's an Ed or something like Eddie or there's something about the Ed, there's something with an E. there's an E name that they want me to highlight. So it's either who they are or who they're with. And the month of July is a birthday. There's something about the celebration in the month of July, or I should say, I apologize, on the 7th of a month, because they show me the white flower with 7. So that means congratulations to happy birthday on the 7th, or congratulations to happy birthday on the 7th month. But that's all kind of coming through in the same way. But your dad seems to be the one who's stepping up forward, plus this gentleman to the right.
My dad was born on the 7th of December.
Okay, so that's your dad's way of acknowledging his date. And then I don't know who this is. I'm not really getting a lot of talkative energy. So sometimes when they do that, it's to let me know that they've been gone for a while, or that they're not like front and center. But they're just like kind of letting me know, like let her know that I'm here. That's why I said it's the male contemporary energy.
Okay.
Alrighty. Thank you so much for calling in and enjoy the site. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Have
Take
a good
care.
Night.